I think all whales are fascinating. They're very majestic beasts. What I feel concerned about as a human being is that we are intruding on their home. I wanted to find ways to help humans coexist with the whales in ways that will reduce our impact to their lives. If you have whales in a habitat with a high level of ship traffic, ship strikes are not an uncommon event. And sound is very important to their well-being. I just often think about what it must be like to be, you know, either bombarded with a lot of noise or, you know, unable to find your mate. The first day on the job in Boston, we had gotten a phone call and learned that a dead right whale had been found off the coast of New Jersey. And we were able to identify it to a 2-year-old male named Friend, who had his tail severed in that ship strike. Back in the early 80s, the population counts were about 250 animals. And when you had such low numbers, any sort of mortality was a concern. We began collecting every right whale carcass to see what we could learn about how they died. The more we looked, the more we found that ship strikes were the major culprit. We brought in shipping industry representatives, port authorities, government officials, and conservationists to come up with a strategy. We learned that if we could reduce the ship's speed from over 13 knots to below 10 knots, it would give the whale an opportunity to avoid the oncoming ship. The strategy we developed to help protect right whales was unprecedented in the shipping world. Over the course of 11 years, we were able to put into place shipping lane changes as well as the speed reduction rule in 2008. And with all those changes, we've been able to dramatically reduce the lethal strike of right whales. What's great about it is now it's being used in other parts of the world. The Smithsonian's implemented shipping lane changes to protect humpbacks off Panama. And there are other countries in the world that are moving this direction as well.